What's up, YouTube? So yesterday was the, I believe, the 13th anniversary of Kobe Bryant scoring 81 points. And today on the First Take, there's an argument that they want to talk about James Harden is a greater offensive player than Kobe was. So let's see what they have to say about that.
Despite losing to the 76ers last night, James Harden had his 20th straight game with 30 or more points. He didn't even play in the fourth quarter. He joined Wilt Chamberlain as the only players in NBA history with 30 points scored in 20 consecutive games. So let's take a look at Harden's elite company here. Harden, Wilt with almost identical numbers and points per game, but Harden playing significantly less minutes per game. Stephen A., is James Harden the best offensive player since MJ?
No, I'm not gonna give him the edge over Kobe yet. Kobe was something special. There's no question about it. There's a reason why.
Yeah, Kobe was definitely something more special, I think, than Harden. Harden may have the stats right now, probably just barely. He doesn't have an 81-point game, you know. But there are other little things that I would probably go with Kobe instead of Harden. A lot of it's your system. A lot of it is who you're playing with. And I know Harden probably has a little bit more on his plate to deal with than what Kobe did back when Kobe was balling out of control for that month. I think because, well, obviously Kobe had Shaq. But I'd like to throw in defense, being a defensive player too. I know we're not talking about that, but that factors into of how you're going to be played. Yeah, let's just see what more they have to say.
We mentioned MJ. We mentioned Kobe. I will acknowledge this. You know, if you want to say offensive player, James Harden's in the conversation because he's phenomenal. And not just in shooting the basketball, putting the ball on the floor, mid-range game, long-range game, step back, free throw shooting, getting to the free throw line. He's a magician on the offensive side of the ball. I think he's the most explosive offensive player in basketball today because consistently he has to do what he has to do, and he has to carry a load, and Mike D'Antoni and his offensive system facilitates James Harden.
Yeah, I will agree that Harden is definitely balling out of control. But once again, I'd have to either go with Kobe or Wilt because, like I said, Kobe can get over the hump. There's been too many times that we've seen James Harden fold under the pressure of being in the playoffs. You know, Kobe can get over that hump. He can get to the big show. He can win the big show. And Harden has yet to show me that, or anybody, that he can get to the big show and win it. You know, that's huge right there. The stats don't mean anything if you can't get over the hump and get to the big show and win it. And that was part of the problem with Kevin Durant and why he had to make that move, because he knew it was getting late in his career. Not really late, but it was getting to the point in his career where you should start winning. You should start getting jewelry. You know, and it's creeping up on that point with James Harden. You know, I mean, the stats don't mean anything if you don't have the jewelry to back it up.
Being able to do that. When Steph Curry explodes, we know there's no one like him. We get all of that. But still in all, James Harden, in terms of consistency on that level, I would give him the edge. But I'm not going to give him the edge over Kobe Bryant, because I think that Kobe Bryant was the closest thing we saw to MJ. And not only that, Kobe Bryant delivered on the defensive side of the ball for most of his career. When he got older, that wasn't the case. But for most of his career, he was a force defensively as well.
James Harden's an incredible offensive player. Yes. But I think a couple things are going on here. He's become overrated offensively. Steph Curry's a better offensive player than James Harden. If Mike D'Antoni was Steph Curry's coach, maybe he'd average 40 points a game. Who knows? Because he would be shooting all the time. You want Steph Curry just to run pick and roll? Well, he's not...
Yeah, I do agree with Max on that. I think Harden and Curry are two different players. You know, Harden's bigger. They create different shots. The system play that they play in, I think it's just a little bit different. So I wouldn't quite compare them. It just depends on your preference of which player you would go with.
As strong as James Harden, he can't get to the basket, finish in the paint the same way James Harden can't get to the free throw line. Okay, let's say he wouldn't get to the free throw line as much. Do you know how much of a better three-point shooter Steph is than James Harden? It's a different universe of ability.
Well, that much is true.
Right, and now imagine him in a D'Antoni system. as the focal point of an offense.
We disagree there.
The point is this. A couple things are happening with James Harden. He's such a well-rounded offensive player because he can score in this era. The two places you want to score from exclusively, three-point line, the paint. And he is better at shooting from the three-point line.
So a three-point line for Harden is one thing, but getting in the paint and comparing that with when Kobe was playing and balling at the point in time when he got to 81 points and it was had the high points per game, I think the game was a little bit different. I think it was a little bit more physical. Today, you can go in the paint and get uncontested, and you can get the calls. But when Kobe was playing, you can get beat up going in that paint. And you can say the same thing for LeBron. I know that's a different video, but, you know, these guys aren't getting touched. They can do whatever they want in the paint. Back when Kobe was balling, you can get beat up. You can get served.
Combination with scoring in the paint than anyone else. But sometimes that idea gets conflated with actually being the best offensive player, like it was with Carmelo once upon a time. Particularly when you play for a coach who encourages you to do that all the time, it inflates your numbers. That's one. Two, so I agree with you. I don't think he's as good offensively as Kobe for his era, let alone MJ. Two, I'm sorry. He's played 700-something regular season games, over 100 postseason games, because the postseason in the NBA is very long. You cannot just limit this conversation to the regular season. When you say offensive player, it is ridiculous to say the highest leverage games don't count at all. Well, in fact, they count more. Stephen A., here's his three-point shooting in the last three postseasons for a team that relies on this. 30% last year, 28% the year before, 31% the year before, and so they lose.
That's a different argument.
That's kind of a different argument, but that still counts big time. Because when you're in the playoffs and you can't shoot for shit, that's a major factor. Because that's why you're there. That's why you've been balling through the regular season, but then you get to the playoffs and you fall apart. That's what I'm saying. Kobe didn't fall apart. Well, he fell apart a couple times, but Kobe got over the hump. We know at least five times. Has Harden? No. And that's when it counts.
For another day, not refuting it. Here's where you and I differ. When we bring up the Curry thing, that's all I want to address here. Mm-hmm. Here's what you have to give credit. We have to take a moment to give credit to Steve Kerr and his coaching staff. You ever see them brothers move the basketball? Mm-hmm. You see the spacing that they create on a basketball court, the way that they move the basketball, the way that they find Steph Curry because he's adroit at moving without the basketball, running around screens and picks and what have you. What I'm saying is if that's your taste, that's your cup of tea, that's cool. But D'Antoni, on many occasions, we find James Harden, and just look at the amount of times he dribbles the basketball. The numbers are exorbitantly high compared to almost everybody else. You look at James Harden dribble the basketball, lots of times he is in ISO situations.
No doubt.
And so what I'm saying to you is this. Steph Curry in ISO situations wouldn't do that.
Once again, that has to do with the system. What type of coach you have, what type of system you're playing, and what type of players are around you.
This gets to...
So it's just a different argument.
We are not talking about...
We're not arguing
about
the same thing.
Right, we're not. Not talking about... Right. Who is scoring? We're talking about offensive player. Remember when I said, I think it was Tom Haberstroh, I apologize if it was someone else, who did the study, when you take away each other all-star from Steph Curry, what happens to the fortunes of the team? They barely change. Steph Curry is the one player the team has enormous success when it's just him, let alone when it's him minus KD or Clay or someone else.
It's from a system.
Wait a minute. Who's running the system? You're saying that ISO scoring James Harden.
We're running out of time.
I'm saying offensive.